can see me only in the public form, very reserved and tight. Only the healers can see me in a very, what to say, the
casual.
So please take out the page. This
you also you read get from, a book and follow.
See, created by the by Swamiji's divine grace to Raji. This girl has written a book, Om Mani Padme Hum. Have you read that book? 27 ways to approach master. It's a poems. Actually, I told her, she's an inmate. She's an inmate. She stays in the ashram. Every month she was earning lakhs in the, what to say, advertisement field, advertisement department. She was young. And she saw DDASP, she just told, I cannot be anywhere else except with you. Then she came away. Tiwari? Tiwari is with me. He was, even 1 month ago, his salary is $25,000 in India. In India. He did ASP and Panam attack over. Now he's in the ashram. I asked her, you write a few poems, English poems. She told, what I can write, Swami? I just gave her a blow on the head. You write. In 10 minutes, she wrote the whole book. Oh. That 27 poems. 27 ways to approach master. Master is a mother, master is a beloved, master is a child, master is a river. You all try to read that 27 poems. In LA, I commented on one poem. Master is a river. On that I commented. You understand? Thousands of people are suffering. I have only two hands. Even if I heal whole day, hardly I can touch 1,000 people per day. But 1,000 is not small. 1,000 is not a big number. It's a very small number when you compare to suffering, people who are suffering. So you will be my hands, extra hands. There is a Purusha Suktam saying, Sahasra Sirsha Purusha Sahasraksha Sahasravat. You are my thousands of hands. Through you all, the divine will heal. The energy will flow. In one life, it's a life after life. Even marriage is one life commitment. Guru-disciple relationship is a life after life. Even, you see, if I die before you die, I'll be in the etheric form to guide you. If you die before I die, you will exactly take the rebirth and search for the next level of the connection. That's what you see, it's like a warning. Ramakrishna used to say before the initiation, he will have a sword in his hand. Actually, sword in his hand. Hey, try to escape. Even the last moment you can escape. you will have a sword in his hand and tell, it's the last moment. Even now you can escape. You have a chance. You want? Escape. Used to. So it's like, initiation is like more or less, not more or less, actually, a commitment with the master to travel and to, for janmas after janmas. You see, in one healer's meet I told, just be a committed healer till your end. You will see at the end of your life, I'll be there exactly when you leave the body. My energy will be there. I'll be there. Not only when you leave the body, even after your leaving the body. It is like a life after life, you will see the divine or the master is with you. These are all not just words. When time comes, you will understand. You see, when you say, when you go and tell your people, you tell some of your friends, come to ASP, it's a great experience. You don't know, words cannot express the experience. Only when you attend, you will understand. When you say all these things, do they believe?
No.
No, nobody will believe. Just maybe out of courtesy, they will not resist. But once they attend, what they say?
Thank you.
They feel awesome, just like that. Only, now when I say all these things, I'll be there when you leave the body and all, you won't understand. Only when time comes, you will understand. Somebody came and told me, someday I enter into an accident, you are there, you only saved me.
Yeah.
You, Ordinarily, if you people say, oh, simply it's a coincidence. But only very few will understand, really Master's protection is there always. In the healing process, you go in. Automatically energy flows and automatically energy does the miracles. So you don't need to do it. See, there are many healers, just simple housewives, just because they are initiated, they have healed even cancers. And for the low BP, high BP, both same chakra, same energy only. But if it is low, it becomes normal, and if it is high also, it becomes normal. Already the whole energy is just programmed. You need to do only one thing, Nityananda password, tuck tuck, over. It will do automatically its process. It is intelligence. Already the everything is programmed. You need to do only one thing. Put the password. That's all. No, put the password and over. Only the initiation is a major thing in this. And one more thing, if you read this book simply and try to practice, nothing will happen. You can't get the result, you can't get the thing. It's only when you are initiated, this book works. Of course, this book will not be available in the sales. It is only for the healers. In India, if any city I visit, 10 to 12% of crowd gather. 10 to 12%. Here 10 to 12% we have not even reached. Karakudi event. Karakudi population is not more than 70,000 or 80,000. They told me. The crowd gathered is more than 7,000. And Tirunavali population is 1 lakh. 12,000 gathered. I am telling, let us spread, that's all.
Definitely.
And one more thing, you know, there are thousands and thousands, we can reach them, it is not a big thing. See, one thing, you don't have the opinion, there are a lot of people who have got the curiosity, they do not know the way. There are many, let us not spare even a single person.
Yes, okay.
Let us not leave even a single stone unturned.
Okay.
So 10, 12 of you should work independently. Not even asking her everything. Even one person cannot decide everything and guide everything. Know the program from website. Each one of you are healing centers now. Start spreading in your own way. Make the handbills, make the flyers, make the things and spread it in your own way.
If you place in the grocery shops, like a lot of people...
Grocery shops, school colleges, don't think only American, Indians. Even you can touch Americans.
And basically...
Because you see, things I speak is for universal.
Yeah. Sometimes you think...
As far as ASP and NSP concerned, whomsoever he may be, he will be touched. It is not for Indians or anybody. The subject which I am speaking is universal. If they are receptive or not, you don't bother that. I will take care. Your work is to spread. When your friend came and told you, you are also not receptive.
No.
How many of you are here who had enough of doubt? But I think once they listen to me, that's enough.
Exactly.
I think we should not leave even a single stone, unturned. What? That's all. One more thing, you see, naturally when they see such a big organizing capacity, they feel somebody else is playing the whole game behind me. But if they come and see around, then only they will understand every color is decided by me. See, naturally, people can't understand. A man who has spent all his life in the spirituality, in the enlightenment, how can he have such a organizing capacity? But fools, they do not know when once a person is enlightened, everything is offered to him. Everything is given to him. That is what they miss to understand. Ramana Maharshi used to decide in which size his photo should be published and which size the name should come. He will sit and decide. People never understand, because once he is gone, it is very easy to cheat yourself in his name. Just to have his photo, there is no need to do anything. But living master means your ego will be just rooted out. Really, people who are ready to throw themselves out. And that's what, last I wanted to announce something. How many namaskars you did for others, that much of result, that much percentage of result you will have from this course. But it will hurt many people, that's why. But really, I tell you, that is the truth. How many Nityanandas you bow down, that much only you will have the result. See, seeing God in me is not a big thing. But seeing in everyone, at least for one moment. It's not that every day you are going to do namaskar, that is different. Every day you are not going to do. At least in that one moment, if you can keep yourself aside and feel the other is God, the energy in everybody is Nityananda. Whenever you listen to the Master's intuition, you will always see only in terms of as a good. Master does, you will see exactly this to get. And moreover, when I tell this type of solutions, I take the responsibility. I feel that I am responsible. That's why I tell that. Before you take the oaths, please be aware that to become a healer, participation in at least 2 ASPs is mandatory. Unless accepted by Swamiji. I tell you one thing. At least see the VCD or video of the whole ASP.
Okay.
Now the whole set is available. Every healers meet when you gather, see the whole thing once more. Then only you will understand how much you missed. Then you will understand how much you missed. If you have done only one ASP, at least next time when I come here, please don't miss the next ASP.
Yeah.
Only then you will understand how much you missed. Before you take the oaths, please be aware that to become a healer. That's all. Oath 1. I hereby swear that the power given to me by Swamiji will be used for the service of all, both animate and inanimate. Your first oath is never to refuse healing to anyone or anything in need of it. Be they people, animals, plants or inanimate objects. Any personal conflict or difference in ideology should never affect your healing. After all, this healing power is not yours to give or refuse. The power is invested in you flows from a divine source. And the divine does not distinguish between right or wrong, saint and sinner. Divine mercy is unconditionally available to all who ask. The healing system I offer you has been created and perfected over the ages by the greatest ancient masters. It is the culmination of centuries of rigorous tapas. In fact, the original system developed by Patanjali was so sophisticated that it was beyond the comprehension of all but a select few. The great spiritual masters who followed him poured their life into simplifying the system and made this precious gift of knowledge available to all. In order to cherish this legacy and truly be benefited by it, you must be willing to drop your ego and share this gift with joy and compassion. The only reason you can have for refusing the healing would be if the person is likely to violate your person or property. If he is a thief, if you feel that by letting him in, he may disturb your property or you, only then you can refuse. But please ensure that your personal opinions are not influencing your decision. Actually, after initiation, you will find that this attitude comes upon you naturally. In the presence of this tremendous healing energy, petty considerations like differences in religion, ideology or personal conflicts simply won't count anymore. For starters, try this exercise. For a moment, close your eyes and imagine that your worst enemy, mother-in-law, someone who has really hurt you in the past, has approached you for healing. Can you bring yourself to consent? If you feel certain, can you heal him without hesitation and humility and love? You are ready to take the next oath. Understand? Even if your worst enemy comes and asks for a healing, you cannot say no. Because this is a gift created by the divine masters, not for one family or one group. It is created for the whole world. One thing. We always have our own prejudices. He is right, he is wrong. But from his view, you are wrong. So you cannot hold on to your views that somebody is right or wrong as far as healing is concerned. It is for the whole world. It is for the whole world. You cannot say no to anybody, even any animals or the plants. So many animals or plants are having the benefits of healing. I have seen so many cases. When I go and touch the plants started giving flowers, started giving drumstick trees. It was not giving fruit. She healed and it started giving fruits. And there are thousands of instances.